K100 Radio. We are live right now, man. O'Reilly's, man, I told you, man, we're going to bring the East Side down tonight, man. We're going to be here for a minute. We live rocking with Ms. Sharon for her 70th birthday celebration, man. We talking to the people, man, that's coming through, showing us some love, giving us some birthday shout-outs, man. That food smelling good out there, man. Yes. That grill popping, man. We got New Orleans in the building, man. Yes. You know what I'm saying? My homie Jew Baby's in the building, man. Holler at my people real quick, bro.
What's happening, people out there in A-Town, Hotland? How y'all doing out there? Faithful are coming every Friday, Saturday. My regular. Right. Ms. Sharon, she a pioneer. I respect her for her birthday, her anniversary that she had a couple of months ago, and she a real woman, you heard?
Absolutely, man. Well, welcome to the broadcast, man. And you know, we just getting some like real people to come through and just talk about, you know, her as a person, man. A lot of people are talking about how she is in the community. You know what I'm saying? She hard, but she fell. You know what I'm saying? Everybody like that's like their second mom, you know what I mean?
Man, so, let me tell you right now, Ms. Sharon. From my years I've been here, and I've been coming here for like the last 5 years strong. People say that what you just said about her.
Right.
But overall, her goodness outweigh her badness.
Right.
You hear
right,
me?
Right.
And she a real woman. I respect her as a second mom. Her son Ed Hood. And it reminds me of a spot like I'm back at home in New Orleans. That's why I always come every week, you know?
Right, exactly. Well, you know, here's the thing about, and you know, everybody's got good and bad qualities, you know what I'm saying? You feel me? But you know, I think when I first met her, she was, I'm telling you, man, when I first met her, the first time I met her, I seen a snap on somebody, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, like that first night, bro, she snapped on somebody.
Right,
I was like,
right,
you know what I'm saying? But then everybody was like, nah, she the sweetest lady, you know what I'm saying? But then I ended up getting a chance to talk to her and getting to know her and, you know, just coming out to some of her events and everything. And she really is, you know what I'm saying? Remind me of my grandmama, because my grandmama didn't play either, you know what I mean?
Yeah, most definitely.
You know, how long you been in Atlanta?
I've been in Atlanta 12 years, big
12
brother.
Years?
From Hurricane Katrina.
Oh, okay. So that's when you came down here after that happened?
I came down here when it happened.
How's it been?
How it is now?
What a transition. I know it was tough, but I met so many people that transitioned over here during that time. But
right.
12 years later, you know.
I must say this, big brother. Uh-huh. I'm glad I had the opportunity to come to Atlanta. I wish I could have came here 25 years ago when I graduated high school.
Yeah.
But the storm ran me here.
Yeah.
I've been here 12 years. I'm loving it.
Right.
And I expect to be here through eternity till God call me home. You hear me?
That's what's up, man. Well, you know, there's been a lot of people that I've met. And, you know, relocating somewhere like that under adversity. But I meet more people than not that have made the best of the transition. You get what I'm saying?
Right, most definitely. Yeah,
you guys are definitely some survivors that came through there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So do you go home and visit? How is it? Do you go home and check out New Orleans every now and then?
I go home like probably about 3 times out of a year.
Uh-huh.
Whether if it's Mardi Gras, the Essence 4th of July, Bayou Classic Thanksgiving time.
Okay.
You hear me? And for sure, the Saints and the Falcons game as well, too. You hear me?
Let me ask you this.
Go ahead,
brother. Do you be down at the stadium down here tailgating and talking your talk?
I'm gonna be honest with you, big brother.
Uh-huh.
I don't be down there because people get that false courage alcohol in the urine.
Yeah.
I go down there, give me a little parking spot, and I try to go in the stadium and enjoy myself. Now, if we win, coming out on Northside Drive, I'm a talking, you hear? But otherwise, I just go in there, just try to stay, you know, busy and everything.
Right.
Mind great with a few people, see what's happening, woo-woo.
Yeah.
And then jet on up and go and enjoy myself, bro.
Absolutely. Man, well, I appreciate you coming over here, man.
I appreciate you, you heard me, boss, man.
You know what
Definitely.
I'm saying? For sure, man.
Thank you.
There's a lot of people in here, man. You know, the thing is getting packed. It's getting crazy. I know it's going to get more and more live, more jumping, man. But we just here to pay homage to Ms. Sharon on her 70th birthday and show some support to O'Reilly's, man. You feel me? New Orleans is in the building. You dig? K100 Radio.